So believe it or not, these guys are actually a type of mushroom. Although the common name for them is an orange ball anemone, the Pseudocorynactis are not anemones at all. It's easy to see why one might think that they were a type of anemone. They share many of the same similarities with some of the popular anemones in the hobby, such as long tentacles and bubble tips. They have a thick crown of tentacles, a fleshy body, and a single large mouth in the center. Despite all these similarities, the Pseudocorynactis is a type of corallimorph, which they seemingly have little to nothing in common with on the surface. Other corallimorphs tend to be flat in appearance, though they do have different textures that are easily differentiated. Appearance isn't the only thing Pseudocorynactis has to separate itself from the mushroom crowd. It's easily the most effective predator as well. Those lovely tentacles, they're incredibly sticky. I would put them on par with the stickiness of, say, a large carpet anemone. Here's a short demonstration of just how sticky they are. It only takes a few seconds for the Pseudocorynactis to first detect my hand and react by sending more tentacles my way. Once it's got a good grip with its nematocysts, I can literally lift the little guy out of the water without him letting go, and that includes the rock that he's anchored to. This stickiness and ability to respond quickly to animals that unfortunately come in contact with it make the Pseudocorynactis a poor choice to house with many small fish or inverts. They're really good at catching and eating anything that wanders too close. I like to keep mine in a refugium of sorts with just macroalgae. In a tank like this, I can still appreciate them for what they are in a nice setting, but I don't have to worry about them eating something like a fox face or a tang. They're more than capable of grabbing and eating large prey items like that. The ones we have right now are fairly small, but they can grow to incredible sizes. The largest one we've ever grown was a good 12 inches across, and could easily eat a nasotang. Just for fun, here's a time lapse showing one of our smaller ones consuming a full-size jumbo shrimp from the grocery store. Anyhow, the Pseudocorynactis can make a really interesting oddball addition if you're willing to take some precautions. Like I said, I made a species-specific tank just for them. That's all from here. Happy reefing.